are watching Crown TV Africa, home of entertainment.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. God bless you. How are you doing?
I'm good, sir.
You're welcome.
Please, sir, may we get to know you, sir?
My name is Apostle Dr. Kasi Chukwu.
Okay. That's you, an apostle, sir.
Yeah, I'm an apostle, and by the grace of God, I'm the General Overseer of Pene of God Power International Ministry, and also the CEO of Pene TV and the CEO of Pene Free Education.
Okay, so being an apostle, and we also understand that you're also a social media activist, and to the people out there, they may think that is quite uncomplimentary. What do you have to say about that, sir?
Well, the Bible said my people perish because of lack of knowledge. You cannot see what is not there. And what you don't know, you can't know. Until you know, you will not know. So anybody who feels that a pastor interfering into politics is against biblical laws, that person is sick of biblical instructions. That person does not know what the Bible is saying. If I write from Genesis to Revelation, it has been the mandate of God for him to select a leader that will lead his people. So today, maybe we are speaking, though many people are not happy. So many people are not happy about it. But I can bet you that it's only 30% that are not happy. But the remaining 70%, they are happy, because the Bible says when the righteous rule, the people rejoice. And I want to say this, that going into politics, I am not into politics, but I am speaking the mind of God in this era, in political era, in those states. I remember a few years ago, I spoke about the presidency, and I told them the mind of God. Today, everybody can see that quite clear, that everything I have said came to pass.
Okay, sir. All right. What do you have to say about the Edo gubernatorial election that is coming up, the campaign and everything that surrounds it, sir?
Well, concerning Edo state election, I want to say I could have not interfered into that, because my spiritual father want me to stay away from it. But I'm not a coward. I want to say this, that I've always revealed to the people of Edo state the mind of God, that Godwin, Obaseki and Shaibo are the people who will take us to the next level. Now, I don't want you to miss this. In 2016, I was against Godwin Obaseki because of Adam Oshomole. I saw what is playing today. I saw it ahead. So I was against him. And I was supporting Pastor Osaige Izeyamu. But when I saw that there was a foul play, I have to pray to God, and God revealed to me that yes, this man, Godwin Obaseki, is a man who have disappointed the enterprises of the former national chairman, which is Adams Oshomole. He have come to put Edo State to the better place where it's supposed to be. And if you drive around the city of Benin, you will see that the people of Edo State are really enjoying the dividendy of democracy. Obaseki is working, good infrastructure, good road. In few months from today, in less than 1 month, Edo State will have 24 hours light. Sir Savior has been the way it was for the past 30 something years, but this man came and renewed it. Look at where, well, I don't want to go into all that, but I think God has spoke to me clearly that if the people of Edo State appreciate grace, they should go for Godwin Obaseki and Shaibo.
Okay, sir. Now, talking about Oshomole's choice, years back he introduced Obaseki to the people. Yeah, letting the people know that Obaseki is the right choice. And then now he's the same person telling the people that Obaseki is rather not the right choice. So how do we relate this?
Yes, it's very clear, because 4 years ago, he wanted to use Obaseki to gain his selfish interests. But Godwin Obaseki, knowing what the people want, I think I will use the word, maybe he repented from following the evil footstep that Oshomole laid down, and he gave us the right thing. Now, ask yourself, why is Oshomole against Obaseki? Did he steal money? Is he not working? Is there any issue? No issue. The issue is that he told Oshomole, we don't need Agbero in Edo State. We don't need people who will oppress our mothers in the market, oppress the youth in the market, fight the youth in the market. All we need are people who are qualified to go for it. People who are educated, who went to university, they are suffering. Some of them are even kasha. Some of them are even walking in on the road. Some of them are doing what they are not supposed to do. But you see a stark illiteracy. An Agbero, someone who has not even gone to primary one. He's a billionaire. Someone who has not even become, who have not touched Biro in his life. He's driving fleet of cars, going with security personnel in the town. And Godwin Obaseki came and said, such a thing should not continue in Edo State. Let this thing regulate. Let Edo be a better place. This man is working. He has not done anything evil that he does not deserve a second term. Though I am not a political analyst, but I just want to push into the book. God spoke to me and said, this man have Edo people at mind. And anybody who is not supporting Godwin Obaseki, he said that person is fighting to go in. In fact, if anybody is not supporting Godwin Obaseki, is a lazy person, someone who is not educated, someone is not learned. If you watch all the people in the other side, they are taught. It's only the people in PDP who are supporting Godwin Obaseki that knows what they are doing. Anybody who have sense, we sit down and said, yes, this governor is working. Let's re-elect him for the second time. And if you watch the rubbish that he's playing in Oshomole regime, you will not try it. You will regret ever attacking any of his convoy. The man is being attacked. PDP poll is being attacked. And nobody is saying anything about it. I gave a prophecy a few months ago. And I said that the people, APC people, they are trying to make sure that this election is canceled. So that they can have their way. And that is why you can see that the people of PDP are maintaining peace. So I keep advising the people of Edo State, let's maintain peace. God's word must surely come to pass.
Okay, sir. Still talking about the gubernatorial election, sir. People have already foreseen that the cloud would be stormy, it would be dark as regards the election day. There will be violence. That's what people think. So, sir, what do you have to tell the people out there that will come out to vote?
Any true born of Edo State will not be afraid of war or violence. In case you are not aware, Edo State fought the British, not Nigeria. When they came to the palace, Edo State fought them. So anybody who is bringing violence should know that it's not only bringing violence to the land, he's bringing violence to the royal throne, he's bringing violence to the security of Edo State, and he's bringing violence to every true born of Edo State. And I will assure you that such a person will not succeed and will not go free. And I want you to know that God is interested in Edo State election.
All right, sir. So finally, sir, you're saying that if this election goes free and fair, void of violence, that Obaseki will certainly win this election.
If this election go free and fair, Pastor Sage Zeyamu will vote for Godwin Obaseki. I'm telling you, mark that word. Within his heart, he knows if they ask him to vote for himself and Godwin Obaseki, he will vote Godwin Obaseki. Plain and clear. Even some people who are following, they know who to vote for. It's not a thing that, except they want to hijack it. Except they want to, you know what is happening now. But we thank God for God. God is still watching. But one thing I want to tell those state people is, Godwin Obaseki win or not, as far as you have voted, wait, let them count your vote. If you cannot wait, go home. Don't put your hand in any violence. If like, let APC come. In the next 4 years, people will regret the action that they took.
All right, thank you very much, sir. It was a wonderful time with you.
It's my pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. That was Apostle Dr. Cassie Chukwu. I am Paul Edi for Crown TV. Thank you.